Goggles Reviews with me, Terry Kay. Now, serious. The Great British Beer Hunt. I think it's finishing this Friday coming up. I'm not sure. But, keep yourselves down to Sainsbury's, because I think that you should encourage them all you can. I mean, I was just, trying to speak to one of the Tesco's buyers. You know, you get the brush off and that, you know. As far as I'm concerned, I thought I'd come up with something sensible, but it's like, nah, not even answered. I'm thinking is that I'm sure one of the supermarket that was on the telly, the People's Supermarket, I'm sure they listened because they started getting local beers in and things like that, and it's less air miles, less carbon footprint and everything else, and you know, all that sort of stuff. So I do digress, but I kind of had a chat about you know, doing regional beers every now and again, and also a kind of a flavour of the month or something like that, you know, something that it's good for everyone. It's, you know, it's going to be, I'll tell you what it is first. You get every month, say, you have a little change of, say, 10 beers or something like that, 5 even, handful of them, you know, just a little sharp end of the hook to bring us in, and we'll fill our trolley with all the other stuff while we're in there, which is what I'll do. You know, I'll go in for a couple of beers and I end up spending 100 quid. But yeah, if you're from London, say, if you've got London supermarkets, then you could have a bit of Colonel in there, or a bit of Fuller, you know, something different from the London Pride on Fuller's and that, you know, some of their different ones, but mainly the smaller brewers, you know, so, you know, a bit of Hackney Brewery. If you're in Norfolk, you'd be, you know, Penfer, Woodford's, Woodford's is Surrey, isn't it? So Suffolk. No, I think now, Edenham's Suffolk. But you know what I mean. You know, I'm trying to think of some small breweries. Iceni, things like that. You know, some of the smaller sort of brewers and that. And get their beers on the shelves. Yeah, they can't supply, not all of them, well, some of them might be able to, but a lot of them can't supply great big whole supermarket chains. But it will be something that, A, you can kind of go, yeah, we're supplying, we're kind of cutting down our carbon footprint, we're supporting the local producers and everything, and kind of looking after the community and trying to support local businesses and smaller businesses as well, and bring them off the ground and get them going, you know. So that also, once you get a brewery going, will provide more competition, which will again be good for the supermarkets, be good for the buyers, for the customers, consumers and everything else. But the promotion of those breweries will also be good for the breweries. So no one's losing out. I'm sure no one's losing out. Yeah, I mean, sometimes the brewers don't earn as much by supplying to the supermarkets, but there's no better kind of advert than people actually drinking the beer, you know. So, let's stop chatting. I'm going to do a dabble babble. Or shall I? Go on, do a dabble babble. We've got two honey beers. I'm going to have to knock these out quick. We've got lavender honey from the Wolf Brewery. Good little brewery. Everything I've added here so far has been lovely. Even though I've had things to say about one of their labels and things, but there you go. The Honey Thief from Williams Brothers, fantastic brewery. The Wolf Brewery are up against something here, and they're slightly different beers, but they're honey beers, I believe. I'm going to read a little bit of Gumpf off of here quick. I may cut this down a bit, this brewery. This is a Norfolk brewery, by the way, this one. Lavender honey, 3.7 ABV. Honey from the Norfolk Lavender Company is added during the brewing process to, of course, hard to read with all that behind it, to give this beer a delicate yet Moorish flavour. So that's nice. That's nice. And this one, Honey Thief. The honey beer. And this one says, a warm golden crafted, golden craft brewed, golden ale craft brewed with a blend of choice malts and hops, to which we add a prepared infusion of honey and whole cone hops. Ooh. God, that sounds lovely. The delicate sweet honey notes balance beautifully with the, right, I don't get it, here we go, of our Cascade and Nelson Sauvin hops. So Nelson Sauvin straight up, Cascade's orangey, tangerine-y, Nelson Sauvin grapey, slightly apple-y, that sort of thing, you know, gooseberry almost. So let's crack these open with my cracky opener, if I can find it. Otherwise, I'm going to have to open it with that. Can't find it. Right, I'm going to have to damage the caps and open it with that. Well, you know, God, who's been playing with my stuff? Ah, there he is. I won't have to do it with that. I've got the old BB. Put him back on your fingertip. Phew. I like to look after me crowns. Shut up. Right. Do you know what? I've just fell in. I think we'll have to have an emergency glass here. Well, there's the thingy there. Very plain. Shave yourself in it. Absolutely lovely. That one's going to go in. Is that clean? It is clean. Hey. That's lovely. That's one. Well, I've glug, 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 glug. It's kind of half filled it. Let the rest sit down. Put it up there. It's a bit wobbly. The box is about to fall in. So that's that one. I'm now going to pour one in to my emergency glass, I think. This is my emergency glass. There it is. You love this. If I can get it open. My emergency glass. Here we go. Emergency glass. Emergency glass. That's my emergency glass. Just pull it out, make sure it's nice and tight. That's my emergency glass. Did I say that enough times? It's a great idea. Pocket pint, it's called. It ain't a pint. It's 470ml at the tops, you know. Which is 472 is an American pint. Oops. Bending out, wasn't it? Well, it hasn't exploded over me. Williams Brothers. And this one is going in to my little emergency pint. Looking good. Looking lovely and sexy. I'm going to leave a little bit of room in there for twirling and smirling. Twirling the core. That's going to fall down there. I'll put it in there. It'll fall down there later if I remember it. Right. Shall we start with that one? This is the carbonation. It's a bit up the glass. But you can see it's doing its thing. Rising there bit by bit up the sides. Let's twirl some of them bits of stuff off the edge. And have a little smell. Lovely. Straight away on the smell. You're getting little honey notes, but they're really cleverly done. You can smell old hops. You can smell like, you know, as if this has been put in late. And in order to put in late, with the honey late, so that nothing's boiled away, nothing's got burnt or anything like that. You got fresh, lovely, treacly sort of honey. really beautiful. I just got some honey from one of these fairs, country fair things, and I just went to a thing where the geezer's got all the empty sort of apiaries, the beehives and everything, and these kind of got all the honey that's fresh from his farm and everything else, and all that, you know, and it smells just like that. So, cool, dip my nose in it. Maybe he's got lavender farm in it, because there's slight hints of lavender there as well. But you're getting nice little biscuity taste, lovely little biscuity taste. Not sure what biscuits. Almost funny enough, like the you know the cones that you get around the ice creams and that. That little cone, as you eat the little dry bottom bit, the kind of the ice creams drip down into a little bit. That sort of slightly vanilla almost flavour that's dripped into it, but the kind of mainly sort of coney wafer. That in there, you've got little, as I said earlier, little grapey notes and gooseberry notes in there. So, cheers everyone. Let's hold on, let's have a smell of the other one. Let's have a twirl and a smell of that one. Much different, quite a fair bit different. This is more peppery. A little bit harsher on the nose from like a little Fugglesy or something like that background note. That little harsh, slightly pepper, sort of slightly mineral edge to it. Earthy almost. And then you've got a very subdued little honey just rubbing the behind the background, you know, just kind of blending over the kind of almost woody notes in the background. Almost a slight hint of whiskey or something like that, but without that alcohol kick. But that smells nice as well. So I think I'm going to start with that one. Cheers, everyone. Chin chin. Nice. Reminds me a little bit of Fuller's Honeydew. It's got that almost lager-like sort of thing going on, but with a little sweetness and little flavours, little ale-like flavours, you know, ale-like flavours. Ow. but that would be a really good beer to kind of bring the geezers over from the geezers and girls over from the lager side. You know, if you've got people like our, who I call Knickers, who's now and again on our kind of Tasty Tuesdays and things like that, old Nicola, who's down at the GBBH serving us, like one of the bar wenches. She would you believe a Foster's drinker. That, I'd aim it at someone like that, and I'd say, yeah, have a go at that. Just enough little kind of Fugglesy background to go, this is still a kind of proper drink, in it. What I call misogynistically, I call it like a man's drink, and that, but there you go. Anyway, let's try this one. Quite sweet. Oh. But nice. These are very different. Almost, you know, I've judged them alongside each other, but almost completely different categories than that. You know, really are. That one there is a little bite, very different. Like them kind of equally as much, really. That one, very different, very kind of lager-like almost. Honey, very subdued. The one thing I'd say is that calling it lavender and honey on the front. Well, I'm not getting a lot of lavender, and I'm not getting a lot of honey. But I suppose, you know, that's the adjunct you're using, so I suppose you've got to kind of put it in the title on it. But it's very subdued, very, very subdued. But it is very, very nice. Very nice. I really like that. The Honey Thief. Almost, but not quite. Almost over honeyed. Almost kind of too much honey. But, yeah, you know, really nice. Yeah, almost too much honey, but kind of still nice in there. It's still lovely. Yeah, tell them about the honey, mummy. That's lovely. Yeah, both really lovely, but both different ends of the spectrum. Now let's see what it's going to be like tasting that one after that one. After the kind of sweet one. I think it'd be completely different. And would you believe? You can taste more honey in that now. And a different honey altogether. That's weird. You could hardly taste the honey. Add extra honey and you can taste... You can taste two honeys. You can taste both. That is really weird. Food and drink are just really weird things. Always surprise me. I've always got air up my nose. Sorry. I've got a moustache that goes... And you seem to get... When you get grey ears, they grow longer than the normal ears in it. And you go... You suddenly get one like that. And you've just shaved it and you go up your nose. Tiggling on your brain or something, you know. Anyway, what do you reckon? This one, dun 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 dun. Try it, buy it, and like it. I reckon you could almost try it, buy it, and love it. That one, that really is nice. Certainly, I would say that that's quite high up as one of the lighter beers in the GBBH. And it, shut up. And it, oh, it's going to do another one yet. About every quarter of an hour it does. And, dun 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 dun. Try it, buy it and like it. Depending on what you have in things, you could try that and buy it and like it, love it as well. Really good beers. Really good beers. I'd give them both something like a 7.5 to 8 out of 10 if I was doing that sort of thing. I don't, but I should do again. I used to mark things out of 100, but, you know, your tastes change from day to day, you know. And but no, these are beautiful. They're really lovely. I'm going to try one thing here. I'm going to pour one into the other and just see what happens. See if when the two honeys get together. Honey, honey, I've got two honeys in with me. Isn't it? And you can actually differentiate in two different honeys. And that is weird. That really is. You've got one darker, almost caramelised honey, if that's such a thing. And one lighter one, and sort of flowery honey. Really nice. See you soon, honeys. Take care. See you in the next one. Don't be late. I'll start without you. I will. I've done it before. Bye. With me.